Hello and welcome back. I am indeed going to look at the Monty Mole series of games. Just a look, not really a review as such. I'm not good enough to play games for long enough to review them. Six games in total, starting in 1984 with Wanted Monty Mole and then continuing up until 1990 and finishing with Impossimole. If you've seen the Bedrooms to Billions documentary, you'll see that you'll know that there's an interview with Peter Harrop, the creator of the character in the first game, where he talks about creating the character in the first game. It's really interesting. If you haven't seen it, check it out. So I'm going to start with, obviously, try and get the games in order. And the first one came out in 1984. That's when we first see Monty Mole. And it was released by Gremlin Graphics, who released tons and tons of good games. There is some duffers as well, don't get me wrong, but they were responsible for some fantastic games. So here we are, we're in the first Monty Mole game. I had this on a compilation and used to play it quite a lot. It's very, very tricky first screen. Took me a long time to work out and get good at completing this. You've got to collect the bucket before you can head into the mine. Now, Monty Mole is one of the sort of iconic Spectrum characters. If you were to ask someone, you know, name some iconic Spectrum characters, they'd likely say Minor Willy, Jetman, Saberman, Dizzy, Magic Knight, and Monty Mole, I would say. Possibly even Joe Blade as well. There's a few of those games. So the premise is that, you know, you've got to keep warm for the winter, so you've got to basically head into the mines and nick all the coal as much as you can find, basically. And it's very, very highly regarded, the first game is, and so were its sequels. I'm not a huge fan of the series. I preferred this game. I got more play out of this game back in the day than I did out of the others. I did play most of them. Impossimole I'd never played until today when I was doing this video, but for me the first game it's easier to pick up and get into than the other ones because the control system is a lot more standard. I always played on keyboard at the time as well, and none of the games have definable keys, and it's only this first one, Wanted, that allows you or that has a sort of standard keyboard layout, Q, A, O, P, and M, which, you know, is fairly easy to get to grips with. Monty on the Run, Alf Wiedersehen Monty, and Impossimole, and Moley Christmas all have preset keys that you can't change, and the layout of them is completely different to what you would normally expect. You know, Q, instead of being up, is the button for to go left. Now, I know people enthuse about the games massively, but I'm not one of them. The control method in the later games really does let them down for me. That's not to say that I don't appreciate that they are good, well-put-together, well-presented games. Now, we move on to The Great Escape, which on the box is Monty is Innocent, and it's kind of like that Jason Bourne film that didn't have Jason Bourne in it and was therefore crap. Because it stars Sam Stoat Safebreaker, the star of the Sam Stoat game, who has got to bust Monty out of jail. Monty's been put inside for nicking all that coal, and it's down to Sam Stoat to bust him out. Now, Sam Stoat appeared in Sam Stoat Safebreaker, another Gremlin game, based on an animal. They also had, obviously, the Monty Mole games, but there was also one called Percy the Potty Pigeon, or just Potty Pigeon. I can't remember. I'll have to sort of have a quick check on that one, see what it was about. But, yeah, I mean, Monty's not in this at all, despite appearing on the loading screen. He may be in it later, I suppose, but I've not seen him anywhere. And the issues with this, for me, are that the baddies, they respawn far too quickly. The collision detection is ropey. The graphics aren't great. And also, there are a couple of occasions where you just get stuck in the game. The Monty Mole sort of like not being in it, if he does appear at the end, it will be sort of like a kind of Force Awakens thing, where, you know, where everyone sort of like spends the best part of a year or 2 years in the run-up to the film's release thinking, oh, yeah, they're all back. Chewie, R2-D2, C-3PO, Han, Leia, and Luke. And Luke's in it for 10 seconds. Probably not even 10 seconds, actually. And he just sort of like looks around and goes, when Ray gives him his lightsaber and he's like, look in his face, he's, where the fuck did you find that? Anyway, you know, so Monty's in prison. What I can't work out is, you know, why doesn't Monty just, when it's exercise time, go into the yard and tunnel his way out? Why does Sam Stokes, it's a bit lazy of him, if you ask me. You know, poor old Sam Stokes got to get in and bust the poor mole out. Now, I don't like this game. I played it once or twice back in the day. On a compilation, and I didn't like it then, but it, you know, it is part of the Monty Mole series, so it has to be included in this review. Now, Monty on the Run, going back to what I said about the series, to start with, it's incredibly difficult to control if you're playing with keys like I do, and the fact that you can't define the keys means that you're spending far too much time thinking about what button to press than actually concentrating on the game, and it takes all the sort of spontaneity out of it. It's a very nice game. All the Monty Mole games, apart from the Sam Stokes one, look really, really nice. They animate well, they're colourful, and the screens are sort of well, deviously thought out in a lot of places. But you see here, this sort of illustrates the difficulty I have with the control. You know, I'm spending time thinking O and P are my left and right, so I'm wasting that split second where I've got to make a decision pressing the button that makes them go up and down instead, because that's what O or P does in this game, and you can't define your own options, which is a major ball ache. Now, it comes from all the Monty Mole games come from Gremlin Graphics, one of the more prolific software houses of back in the day, and they brought us classics such as, you know, the Jack and the Nipper games, Jack the Nipper games, Bounder, Thing on a Spring, The Way of the Tiger games, my absolute all-time favourite Gremlin Graphics game is Death Wish 3. I love that game, that's fantastic. You know, bear in mind how crap the film is, you know, the actual game itself is fantastic. Now, I'm only on screen, this is the third screen already, and all the difficulties I've been having with the controls are highlighted here. Anyway, Auf Wiedersehen Pet is listed right above Auf Wiedersehen Monty on the World of Spectrum. And I accidentally clicked on this instead of Monty. Don't do the same, because that is one of the worst games I've ever, ever played. So, here we go. Auf Wiedersehen Monty. Monty has now escaped the authorities and is looking to resettle on an island that he wants to buy, and so he can retire and be in peace. And he's got to, you know, it's more of the same sort of fare, really. Again, very, very nice looking game. Again, very frustrating controls for me. Some people may well have got on fantastically well with them, but as I say, I didn't. An absolutely brilliant 128K soundtrack. And a new mechanic's introduced in this game. You can see that the platforms add a kind of spring effect to them. So Monty can build up enough momentum by repeatedly jumping to go higher and higher and higher until eventually he can reach previously out of reach places. Now, again, I remember at the time this game being really, really well received and having an awful lot of fans. But like I say, I'm not one of them. I would love to be, because, you know, I think that I'm missing out on something. It's only my ineptitude at gameplay that means the controls really do stifle the experience for me on these Monty Mole games. So I'm just going to let this Alpha Design segment play out a bit before we move on to game number 5, Impossimole. Here we are, Impossimole from Core Design, and nothing ever happened, became of them, did it? Now, I can't work this game out for the life of me. They've changed it completely, and there's some old guff about some alien race have called to Monty when he's lying on the beach of his island and given him superpowers and asked him to save... save their race or whatever it is, and it's just a bizarre game, and unfortunately it's not a good game. Monty looks completely different from what he has in any of the previous games. It's more a side-scrolling shooter or a sort of platformy game than, you know, the classic Monty Mole games. It's just totally bizarre. It's not a very good game at all. I don't like this one. It's slow. It's clunky. It looks all right. But you would never consider that was a Monty Mole. You would never, if in a million years, guess that that was the Monty Mole character if someone asked you who it was, because it's just not recognisable as Monty Mole. He's wearing a cape, for God's sake. Well, it's just, I can't really explain this game. It's it doesn't play well at all. It's just not good. Not good. I'll leave it there. It's not good. I'm not enjoying this game. Now, those of you who saw my Chucky Egg videos will know that I'm no good at jumping on ropes. Now, this is Moley Christmas. This is probably one of the most difficult games I've ever played. Probably really easy for everyone else on the planet. But this was a freebie with Your Sinclair. It's one of their cover games that they gave away one Christmas. And the premise of it is that Monty's at the Your Sinclair office. Excuse me. And has to help cobble together the Christmas edition of the magazine. Now, it is so tricky. I'll tell you now, on this video, I don't get off this screen. It's really, 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 really difficult. Perhaps it shouldn't. Well, perhaps it isn't. But as a freebie, a free sort of cover tape with a magazine, it's you know, you can't knock it. I mean, it's clearly Monty Mole. It's clearly the same sort of gameplay mechanic from the Monty Mole games. It's just bastard hard. See, there's large bosomed employees down the bottom there. You've got to get by them. And you've got like an energy gauge as well, which goes down even if you're not doing anything really. So, you know, once that hits zero, it's curtains for the old for the mole. So that's it. That's the Monty Mole games. Thank you ever so much for watching. I hope you have a